Hi guys, I've got another story for you today. This one's called Galimoto, and I would like you to find a comfortable place to listen to it. This one's a little bit longer. It's written by Karen Williams. I want you to think by looking at the picture what Galimoto might mean. He's making a Galimoto right there, and I will tell you what it is. A Galimoto means car in Chikichewa, the national language of Malawi, Africa. It's also the name for a type of push toy made by children. Old wires or sticks, corn stalks, and pieces of yam are shaped into cars, trucks, bicycles, trains, and helicopters. All of these intricate toys are known as galimoto. So here we go. Kondi opened an old shoebox and looked inside. These were his things. They belonged to him. Inside the box, there was a ball made of many old plastic bags, tightly wrapped with string. There was a knife Kondi had made from a piece of tin can, and a dancing man he had made from dried corn stalks. In Kondi's box, there was also some scraps of wire. He had been saving the wires for something special. Now he took them and the knife from his box. So I want you to look carefully at his box and where he lives. What do you guys notice? "I shall make a galimoto," Kondi told his brother Ufulu. Ufulu laughed. "A boy with only 7 years cannot make such a toy. You don't have enough wire." "I will get enough wire," Kondi answered. So, what are some problems with his plan? Think about that for a minute. Kondi took his knife and wire scraps and went to the home of his friend, Gift. "I want your wires," Kondi told Gift. "I will give you my knife for them." "Why do you want the wires?" Gift asked. "I want to make a galimoto," Kondi answered. Gift ran his fingers over the tin knife. "It is a good knife. I could make a dancing man with it." Gift took a handful of wires from his box of things and gave them to Kondi. "That's not enough wire for a galimoto," he told his friend. "I will find enough wire," Kondi said. Kondi put his wires into an old white plastic bag and took them to the shop of his uncle. "Good day, second son of my brother," his uncle greeted him. "How can I help you?" "I want some wire," Kondi told his uncle. "How will you pay for it?" "Well, I have no money," Kondi answered. "But you have wires on your old packaging boxes from the city. They would make a fine galimoto." "So you want to make a galimoto? The son of my brother is a clever boy. Take the wires." So I want you to look and see what are they selling in that family store right there. Chee-chee, chee-chee. Kondi could hear the grinder at the flour mill. Many women with babies tied on their backs waited in the hot sun. Others arrived carrying heavy baskets of maize on their heads. Kondi squeezed through the crowd. He was very near the front door when someone grabbed him. The woman began yelling angrily, "Stop that one! He goes out of turn!" Kondi was being pushed and shoved. Suddenly, the mill stopped grinding. "What is it?" the miller shouted. The women pointed at Kondi. "Ah, no," Kondi said. "I have no maize to grind. I only want wires for a galimoto." He opened his bag for them to see. "Playthings? For this you keep us waiting?" the women grumbled angrily. "One cannot eat wires." An old, toothless woman shook her hand at Kondi. The miller shrugged. "Oh, there are some wires out back. Take those and go." In the back of the mill, there was an open door. Inside the door was a pile of old motor parts. There, Kondi found some very thin wires wrapped in red and yellow and green plastic. "I can scrape the coating off," Kondi thought. "These wires will hold my galimoto together." Still, he did not have enough for Galimoto. I'm seeing a lot of determination going on with this kid right now. Kondi passed some young children playing on an anthill. One was Mundi, the small sister of his friend Gift. She had a fine, long piece of wire, which she stuck into the hard dirt. "Little friend," Kondi asked as he came nearer, "you cannot catch an ant that way. Go fetch some water, for with that and a stick, we will fool them." When Mundi came back, Kondi poured the water around one of the holes. "Now they will think that the rains have begun," he exclaimed. Then he stuck a stick down the hole. Gently, he pulled it out, and on the end was a large ant. My stick is better than wire for catching ants. You may have the stick, and I will take the wire. Condi knew there was a trash heap behind the bicycle repair shop, but the gate was locked. Condi climbed over the fence. In the courtyard, he found some broken, bent spokes from a bicycle. He climbed back over the fence with his bag. Thief! Help! Police! Thief! Condi heard a voice call. Children came running from the marketplace. Men came running from the shops. They made a circle around Condi. Thief! Thief! They chanted, pointing at Condi. A policeman arrived. He grabbed Condi by the shoulder. What are you doing? He asked. Condi showed the policeman his wires. I want a Galimoto, he exclaimed. I need these wires. Galimoto, the crowd murmured. Galimoto. They shook their heads and went back to their business. Take your wires and go, the policeman told Condi. Condi took his wires back to the shade of the red flame trees in his village. Nearby, his mother and sisters pounded their maize. They sang of the hard work they were doing. Condi sorted his wires. There were thick pieces and thin pieces. Some wires were long and some were short. Condi banged the bent and twisted ones with a stone to straighten them. Then he began. The thick wires made the frame. He wrapped the very thinnest wires at the joints to hold the Galimoto together. My Galimoto will be a pickup, Condi planned. It will carry maize to the city, and it will have an antenna for the radio, he smiled. Condi worked all afternoon. He pounded the strongest wires around a pipe to make the round wheels. A sturdy piece of bamboo made the rod for the steering wheel. Finally, the warm, toasty smell of maize porridge cooking over the village fires told Condi it was time to go home. His brothers and sisters admired his work. So you found enough wire, Lafu said. Yes, Condi agreed. He parked his Galimoto next to his box of things and ate his supper. Let the moon be bright for us to play and sing tonight. Condi could hear his friends singing in the distance. They were calling him to play. So Lafu, Ifulu had learned something about his brother right here. So what do you think he will say the next time Condi tells him his plans to create or to do something? Now he carefully guided his Galimoto over the dusty path. Galimoto! Someone cheered. And one by one, Condi's friends formed a line behind him. Yee! Galimoto! Galimoto! They began to chant. This must be fun. What do you think Condi's friends think of his new Galimoto? Condi saw the shadow of his Galimoto cast by the moonlight racing alongside. It's a fine Galimoto, he thought. Galimoto, he thought proudly. Perhaps tomorrow I shall make my Galimoto into an ambulance or an airplane or a helicopter. And in this page, he's dreaming. What is he dreaming about? Carefully. I hope you guys enjoyed this story. And I hope you are having a great day. I miss you guys so much. Bye.